Hey guys, hope you're having a great day. So today I just wanted to make a quick video, just if anybody else has dealt with this issue in the past. Right next to me at my mom's house, we have this weeping white birch. I believe that's the type that it is, but it's definitely just a weeping birch. It's gonna get really big. Right now it's probably about, the top there is maybe like 15 feet, somewhere like that, like 12, 15 feet tall. But right now it is middle of April, or early to mid-April, that's what I meant to say. And on the branches here, the leaves are, you could see all the buds and they're turning green, but the leaves are not out yet. The biggest issue that I had with this tree last year, which you could see from the title of this video, is that it had birch blight, I believe that's what it was called. So it was just all these little black spots. And then what eventually happens is those black spots will spread to other leaves and other stuff like that. And then they'll turn around like the, just around those black spots, it'll be kind of yellowish in color. And what happens is it prevents the leaves from being able to photosynthesize. And then those leaves basically become useless. And then the tree starts to drop the leaves. So this tree we planted last June, I think it was like the middle of June, didn't really have much of an issue. Maybe there was some spots on it, but as the season progressed, it started to get more and more of those spots. The blight kind of went throughout the whole tree and then it started dropping leaves. So what we did was we sprayed it with a spray. I'll get it right now, actually. So the one that I got is from Dr. Earth's. So it's called Dr. Earth Final Stop Disease Control Fungicide. It's organic, and I'll show you the direction or the ingredients that it's made out of, but that helps stop the blight from spreading. If you look on the back here, you can see the active ingredients. It's rosemary oil, clove oil, peppermint oil. So those are like the active ingredients that will help prevent that. And then you could see, just so I can show you another close up, the leaves have not emerged yet, but they're just about to. So what we're doing this year is I'm just going to spray it now to preventatively prevent that blight from really kind of getting started and then spreading on all of them. So I'm going to spray it now, right before like the leaves emerge, while the buds are still kind of like swelling right now. So that way if there's anything left from last year, that it can hopefully be gone. And then once the leaves do emerge again, then I'm going to spray it again, just kind of give all the leaves that just emerged like a nice barrier to protect themselves from the blight. And then if I do start to see any more, then I'll spray it again too. I shouldn't have to do it too often, maybe like once a month or so throughout the summer, but I really shouldn't have to do it more than a couple or a few times during the season. So all I'm really going to do is just kind of spray it, just try to cover the branches as much as I possibly can, and that'll be it. All right, so you can see that the branches, they're looking a little bit darker now, kind of shiny. And I just wanted to say, I was trying to like cover my face as much as I could. It's organic stuff, so you don't have to worry about it too much. But obviously try not to breathe it in. And then I also was trying to work with the wind. So obviously don't spray it where it's gonna come back at you in the wind. But yeah, you could see it's looking really good. Like all of these leaves are just about to emerge. And I am happy about this because it was starting to drop its leaves a little early last year, but the tree looks like it's coming back really, really healthy, especially at the top. And then with the top, there wasn't any really great way for me to spray it. I certainly could have gotten a ladder. So I just tried my best to get it. But I think it was more of an issue being towards the ground and especially like stuff that was kind of towards the ground. So I also cut this back a little bit, so that way it's at least about a foot off of the ground. And that's about it. The only thing I will say is make sure that you spray the trunk, which I actually didn't do, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. And that's about it. I will say too that I'm not like an expert on that kind of stuff and taking care of it, but I talked to some people like at the place that we got this from. That's what they said to do, and they said that it would be fine this season after spraying it with that last year, which it seems like it's coming back really, really well. But yeah, this is just a nice simple way to do it. There's some other products as well. I'll look up to see what other types of products you can use if you can't find the Dr. Earth stuff. But I would say definitely try to go organic as much as you can, so that way it's safe, so that way when you're spraying it, if you have any kids or pets, like we have a couple cats that our neighbors, like our neighbors have outdoor cats, and they go around the lawn and you know, that kind of stuff. So I want to make sure that I use stuff that's safe for them. But yeah, that's all I have for this video. And that's about it. So I will see you guys in the next one. I forgot something. As I was putting this away in the garage, I realized that I forgot to mention one more thing. Because I'm putting this on before the leaves are out, it doesn't really matter as much what time to do it. It's still better to put this on in the evening or the morning, because it's better for any insects that would go by the tree or anything else really. But once the leaves are on the tree, you definitely want to put it on either in the morning or at night, because that can actually burn the leaves. If you do spray it like in the middle of the day on like a hot, hot summer day. Like I said, it's not that big of a deal now. It's not a hot day outside today. And the leaves aren't, you know, on the tree yet. But definitely when you have the leaves on the tree and you're spraying it, that's when you want to be mindful of it. It says it on the container anyway, so I would say just whatever product you use, read through all the directions thoroughly and try to follow them as best as you can. Again, I should really practice what I preach. But as long as you read the stuff on the back, then you should be fine. I just wanted to give some sort of visual representation just so that could be helpful. And what I will say too is as that tree grows, it's not gonna be like the easiest thing to try to spray the whole entire tree. But as long as you try your best trying to spray it, then you should be good. But I think it's gonna be a lot better this year than it was last year.